Morning dear students, welcome back to CLE Science Online class. I hope you all are absolutely fine. So dear students, in last class we have completed the concept of physical properties of the metals. Now let's discuss the chemical properties of the metals, how the metal is reacts with the environment. Okay, so dear students, in last class itself I have given you reactivity series of the metals. So by referring those reactivity series of the metal, easily you can utilize that how the metal is reacting with the environment. Okay, now let's discuss one by one the metals is reacting with environment. Okay dear students, so now we are going to start here. Dear students, the first chemical properties of the metals I am going to discuss here, the reaction of metals with oxygen. So dear students, how you can analyze this reactions of metals with the oxygen? So we have a one simple example about the rusted iron. Okay, so it is the reaction of iron metal with oxygen. So when iron reacts with the moist air, it forms a rust. Okay, so this brown color you can analyze here, that is nothing but the moist air which reacts it with the water and it forms a rust. Okay, and this rust is nothing but the iron oxide. And articles made of iron such as a grills, fencing, get rusted because of reaction with moist air. So dear students, iron is readily reacted with oxygen, so that's why you can find this reaction in our environment itself, where the reactions of metals with oxygen takes place. So dear students, when we are leading chemistry, each and everything we cannot express in a sentence formation, so that's why we are using the chemical representation to explain the sentences. So dear students, these three sentences, that is when iron reacts with moist air, it forms rust, rust is iron oxide, articles made of iron such as a grills, fencing. Okay, no need to describe this all the things if you know how to write this sentence in the chemical representation. So dear students, don't go for the balancing the chemical equation, just think and how to write. Okay, so what is the chemical representation of iron, that is the Fe? What is the chemical representation of the oxygen, that is O2? It gives rise the Fe2O3. Okay, it gives rise the Fe2O3, it is nothing but the rust. Okay, so the chemical formula of the rust is nothing but the Fe2O3. Okay dear students, so dear students, the numbers is front of iron and oxygen you are observing here, that is the different criteria. Okay, actually one particular one chapter is there in a 10th standard, there you are going to learn how to balance the chemical reaction. Okay dear students, so here the 4 Fe plus 3 O2 is gives rise the 2 Fe2O3. Okay, so this is the chemical representation about the iron is reacting with the oxygen. Okay, so here the question can be asked, what is the formula of rust iron? So the answer you must to know, it is nothing but the Fe2O3. Okay, so dear students, this is the reaction between the iron and the oxygen. This rust is a reddish brown in color and it is iron oxide. So dear students, when metal is reacting with oxygen, it represented as a metal oxide. So here which metal we have considered, we have considered about the iron. Iron is reacted with the oxygen, it gives rise the iron oxide. This iron oxide is a basic in nature, it turns red blue, litmus blue. So dear students, what do you mean by red litmus blue? Litmus paper, in last class when you are learning about the acid base concept, what you have learned there? Okay, so for checking the acidic property and basic property, we can use the indicator as litmus paper. Okay, so for base paper, base substances. Which litmus paper we are taking? We are taking the red litmus paper. Okay, so the substance, if the substance is a basic in nature, it should shows a blue in color. So iron oxide is a basic in nature, where it turns red litmus blue color. Okay, so here what we have learned, the chemical properties of the metals, in that the iron is reacting with the oxygen, it gives the iron oxide. Iron oxide formula is Fe2O3. Which color it have? It have the brown in color. So for checking the acidity or basic property of that rusted iron, we can use the red litmus paper, which showing the red turns into blue in color. So this is the reaction between the iron metal with the oxygen. Okay, dear students. Now let's take another example about the copper. Okay, copper is also very readily reacted with oxygen. Okay, so dear students, when copper vessel is exposed to moist air for an extended time means there is a no time limit. Okay, so extended time means for a long days, it develops a green layer on its surface. So you can find the green layer on its surface. This copper corrodes by oxidation, during which reacts with the oxygen with the air to make a oxide. So dear students, how the iron is making oxide? In similar way, when the copper is reacting with oxygen, it makes their oxide, like a copper oxide. Then oxide then again combine with the carbon dioxide to form a copper carbonate, which provides it's a green color. Okay dear students, so here it is a two step condition. Okay, what is that two step condition? In the first condition, copper is reacting with oxygen. Okay, copper is reacting with oxygen, copper is reacting with oxygen, it gives rise the Cu2O, okay, or you can say CuO, okay, copper oxide. Again it is reacted with copper, is reacted with the carbon dioxide as a Cu2O3. Okay, that is the Cu2O3. So this is the formula of copper carbonate. Okay, Cu2CO3. Okay, now let's discuss how you are going to write this. So dear students, how you are going to write this equation? Okay, recall it what we have learned in the last slide. Okay, so copper, it is nothing but the representation of Cu. It is the copper when it is reacting with the oxygen. Okay, so dear students, in the moist air, which are the components should be present? The components of air having the lots of mixture. Okay, what are those mixture? It's have a variety of gases, varieties of some of the water contains present in the atmosphere. So here when we are considering the moist air, it considered to be a oxygen, H2O as a water, and the carbon dioxide. Then it gives the formation of copper hydroxide and the copper carbonate, okay, which is nothing but the mixture of green coating on the object. So dear students, the main thing which is present in the present on the surface of copper, that is a green in color. What is that component? That is the copper hydroxide and the copper carbonate. The green layer, it is nothing but the mixture of these two objects, that is the copper hydroxide and the copper carbonate, which is a green coating object. You may find after keeping the vessel of copper for a long time. Okay, so how it reaction can be analyzed? So when the copper is reacting with the oxygen, it gives the formation of copper hydroxide, and later on, due to the presence of water and the carbon dioxide, it gives the greenish color. That greenish color is the mixture of two substances, or you can say two product form, that is the copper hydroxide and the copper carbonate. So, 1 mark question can be asked. The green color presents which is present on the copper surface. So, write the mixture components with their formula, okay. So, at that time you have to write this answer itself, that is a green coating object which is present on the copper vessel is copper hydroxide and the copper carbonate. So, dear students, today we have learned totally two reactions about the metal, which is very, very important for 2 marks or 3 marks. So, these two reactions is you have to be read it once again, and after that if you are finding any difficulty to understand the concept, just approach me once again, I can explain you, okay. So, for writing the chemical reactions, okay, you need more practice, okay, dear students. Let's meet in the next class. Have a good day. Bye bye.